The Healing Room, where we identify trauma, setbacks, and delays, release them so we are no longer held back by pain, anger, bitterness, or low self-esteem. When entering the healing room, we come with expectations for our healing journey to begin, where we cleanse our spirits, energies, and affirm who we are. Also, learn how to love ourselves holistically. All are welcome and no one is judged. Welcome to the healing room. This healing room session is all about healing from childhood trauma. I would ask you to settle in, make sure you're in a quiet space, and have yourself a pen and notepad to do some journaling. Once again, welcome into the healing room. We're going to go into now a 5 minutes of meditation and deep breathing to settle ourselves, to get our heart rates calm down as we allow ourselves to go back into history, to go back to remember the trauma that have transpired in our lives, in our childhood. We're going to start our meditation session by breathing in to the count of four, holding it for four, and releasing at four. Breathe in, two, three, four. Hold, two, three, four. Breathe out, two, three, four. We're breathing in through our nose for the count of four, holding it for four, breathing out for four. We're going to do this for the next 5 minutes. Here we go. As we now exit our time of meditation, this is the part where we now identify the trauma that needs to be released and healed. And the first trauma that we're going to deal with from our childhood is a trauma from the womb. Trauma from the womb on conception. We may not physically understand the trauma that took place in our conception via our mother telling us how we were conceived. And so here we go now, releasing any trauma that take place in the womb upon our conception, whether it's by rape, whether it's by force, whether it's by incest, whether it's by molestation, but the trauma of the womb. Whether when our mother found out that she was pregnant, she didn't want that pregnancy, so that trauma of rejection from the womb, or our father didn't want the pregnancy, and so there again, the rejection from the womb. Let us release any trauma that we may have experienced from the womb. We release any and all trauma that may have occurred in the womb at this time. The next trauma that we are going to deal with is trauma in birth. When we're coming out of that birthing canal, and maybe the birthing canal did not expand wide enough to allow us to come out freely, and they may have had to use forceps, or maybe they had to rush our mother into the emergency theater and perform a C-section. And so we release every trauma from birth in our birthing process. Also, the trauma that our mother may have been physically abused while we were in the womb and upon our coming out through the birthing canal. Maybe the trauma of her having to hurry up and be sutured so we can get out. Trauma of being stuck in that birthing canal. We release the birthing trauma we may have received at this time. As we step into the next trauma we may have suffered as a child in our childhood, from toddler to 5 years old, we examine ourselves and bring back into recollection any traumas we may have suffered as a toddler to the age of 5 years old. As we go deep into our memory, flashbacks of maybe being fondled by a sibling, fondled by an adult, an uncle, an aunt, by a family friend, maybe we've suffered from rape, molestation, incest, whether by fondling of hand or by oral or by penetration. We release ourselves from these traumas. They no longer will have a strong hold on us. The other traumas we may suffer between toddler and 5 years old is trauma of abuse. That is verbal abuse or physical abuse. Whether it's neglect and starvation, the trauma of being left in a room or locked in a room, or left at home by ourselves. Childhood trauma. We are releasing all of the incidents that have occurred in our lives. From our conception in the womb to the birthing process to when we were toddlers to 5 years old. I give you 2 minutes just to release, letting it go, letting it go, letting all of the trauma, all of the hurt, all of the pain, all of the bitterness, all of the anger, letting it go. Let it go. They no longer have a stronghold on you. You no longer are bound by this trauma. So we release that person, that mother, that father, that uncle, that aunt, that sister, that brother, that cousin, that family friend, that teacher, that pastor, that leader, that neighbor, that babysitter, that caregiver. We release them at this time. Now we are going to go into a time of house cleaning, cleansing ourselves as we say these words. I no longer allow the negative energy of trauma from my childhood to keep me in bondage or stagnated to low self-esteem. Emotional unbalance, self-hate, anger, bitter, and feeling not good enough. I release it and send it on its way. Negative energy, I take back my self-worth, inner peace, emotional stability, emotional independence, healing, confidence, joy, purpose, and confidence to soar. I am all that the I am say I am. I'm going to repeat it one more time. I no longer allow the negative energy of trauma from my childhood to keep me in bondage or stagnated to low self-esteem, emotional unbalance, self-hate, anger, bitterness, and feeling not good enough. I release it and sent it on its way. Negative energy, I take back my self-worth, inner peace, emotional stability, emotional independence, healing, confidence, joy, purpose, and confidence to soar. I am all that the I am say I am. Yes, very good. That's a cleansing of the house and sending out all of that trauma and all of that negative energy. Next, we are going to go into affirmation. I am affirmation. And with this affirmation, it's not limited to just what I say here, but you can also add on to it, extend it to all the things that you need to affirm in yourself. So we're going to start the I am affirmation. And I'm going to repeat each one 3 times. I am no longer tied to, I am no longer tied to that trauma. I am no longer tied to that trauma. I am no longer tied to that trauma. I am completely and totally healed. I am completely and totally healed. I am completely and totally healed. I am a divine creation. I am a divine creation. I am a divine creation. I am not what I have been through. I am not what I have been through. I am not what I have been through. I am emotionally stable. I am emotionally stable. I am emotionally stable. I am mentally healed. I am mentally healed. I am mentally healed. I am spiritually in alignment with the divine creator. I am spiritually in alignment with the divine creator. I am spiritually in alignment with the divine creator. I am financially stable. I am financially stable. I am financially stable. I am walking in my divine purpose. I am walking in my divine purpose. I am walking in my divine purpose. I am walking in love. I am walking in love. I am walking in love. I am walking in forgiveness. I am walking in forgiveness. I am walking in forgiveness. I am an overcomer. I am an overcomer. I am an overcomer. I am victorious. I am victorious. I am victorious. I am who the I am say that I am. And so you can add to your affirmation all that you need to add to it at any given time. I say to you, know your self-worth, words of encouragement as you go forward in your healing process. Self-worth, know your self-worth. Maintain your inner peace. Continue to take hold of your emotional stability. Continue to take charge of your emotional independence. Continue to walk in your self-healing. Knowing what makes you happy. You must know what makes you happy. Letting go of all of the trauma, the hurt, the pain, the bitterness. You must know when to let it all go. And continue to speak words of affirmation over yourself. I want to encourage you to take time out for yourself to continue in your healing. Go for a walk in nature. Go and sit by the beach. Find music that would soothe and comfort you. And hug yourself. Know this. You are not a victim, but you are victorious. You are not what happened to you. Thank you.